best is yet to come. The best is yet to come.
Soon as I stop worrying,
worrying how the story ends,
I can let go.
I let go in the
heart. I can let God, let Him have,
let God
have His way back
when things start happening.
Things start happening.
I start looking at back.
Oh, when I let go. Let God let go, and let God let go.
Why are you clapping? Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for joining me for this edition of the Lexi Show. I'm here on location at St. Louis, Missouri, at Faith Miracle Temple, headed by the angel of this house, Bishop Larry Baylor. Give it up for Bishop right now. He's been in prayer all day, so he's real serious. He's been praying for this ministry and praying for everybody. Thank you so much for allowing us to be in your house once again. I'm so glad you're here because, you know, you hear the songs on the radio, you have it in your car, and you praise and worship, and you fall on the floor, and your face is in the floor, and you're laying prostrate, and you're going, oh, my God, this is such a wonderful song. This song is taking me in, but you may not know the story behind the song, and tonight you're going to learn a little bit about that. With me, I have the wonderful artist, a great friend of mine that I love so much, Minister DeWayne Woods is in the building.
That's great.
Talk to the people.
Yes.
And I'm so glad you're here because I've been knowing you long before Let Go and Let God.
Most definitely.
And you won Song of the Year.
Yes.
For that song.
Yes.
So what?
Oh.
So what?
The Bible say rejoice with them that rejoice. Now, come on now.
True. You're so awesome, and I am just, as they say, godly proud of you because I knew you before the bow ties and the button-down shirt. And you look so crisp, sir. You look crisp this evening.
Thank you. I was coming on Lexi's show, so I had to make sure that I did the right thing. You know, you can't, with this one, doesn't she look wonderful, you guys?
Whatever. Whatever, Dwayne.
You ain't gonna show me up on your own show.
I got you. You know, we go back. I don't know if any of you have ever seen the plays, you know, Mama Don't. Mm-hmm. Mama baked a sweet potato pie, and Mama, I want to sing, and I want. There was a play that we were on. I was in a play called not the one I'm about to mention, but okay. Listen to Your Woman, and there's just so many out there. But we were on a play together.
Yes.
A long time ago, not that long ago, because I'm young.
That's right. We both are.
Right. A long time ago, called A Good Man Is Hard to Find. You remember that? And this young man was in that play and just wrecked every single night, brought the house down, and it was ridiculous. And none of us had any money.
We
call it the Chitlin' Circuit because we would just, you know, go around, you make your little money every week, and we would just travel and do our thing. And try to take care of home.
In the process. What she's not going to tell y'all is she played my mother in the show. That's going to be edited, I'm pretty sure.
That'll never make it on TV. On the cutting room floor, sir. Absolutely. But yeah, I mean, they cast us in those roles. How old were you when we were on the road together?
When we were out, I was 17.
Yep.
I was a baby. My mother allowed me to be able to finish high school on the road with the play. She knew the destiny that was on the inside of me, and she knew that there was so much that I had to do. So I was probably the youngest out there. I had to sign a permission slip to go on the road.
Yep. Yep. But you've been singing all your life.
All my life. I don't know anything else but to sing.
Yeah. And you grew up in Kansas City?
Kansas City, you know that.
Yeah.
See, I'm at home, so all y'all my cousin. I just want y'all to know. I'm all y'all my cousin. And I'm not in Kansas City, but to be in the wonderful state of Missouri, it feels so good to come home. So when you told me I was coming here, I was excited about it. Come on, clap. We had a family reunion now. Clap on clap.
So you've been in church all your life?
I've been in church all my life. I was born, and this is really funny. I say this all the time. My mother had a plan. She knew when I was going to be born. She knew the day I was going to be born, so she planned out the entire day. I was born on a Sunday afternoon. My mother was a singer in church, so she said, I'm going to go to church. I have to lead a song. She went to church. She led her song. She said, I was going to go home and warm up the food for the family. I was going to go to the hospital. I was going to have you, and there was a movie that she wanted to watch that night. It was something with Richard Pryor. I can't even remember the name of the movie, but she did it in that order. I was born at like 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so it was amazing that she planned it out and knew exactly what was gonna happen.
And it worked out for her.
It worked out. She watched her movie. That was the one thing she wanted. She didn't care about having me. She wanted to see that movie.
That's awesome. So you grew up in church all your life, and then your mom gave you permission to go out on the plays. That, at 17,
yeah.
For her to let you go like
it was
that.
It was a pull, but like I said, one of the things that, I've always been a singer. I mean, I did my first concert at Mount Vernon Missionary Baptist Church in Kansas City, Missouri, when I was 5 years old, a full six-song concert. Like, I can't remember what I sang, but it was too long ago. But she's always known what God had in store for me and what God really wanted me to do. So when I, this is really funny. When I wanted to go on the play, I'm a little kid. So I do stuff that little kids do. So I would write my mother notes every night. I would write her a little letter and put it on her bed so she would see it. Mama, please, can I go out with the play? Can I please do this? Can I please do that? And she would read the notes and put them to the side. And she just said that she would lay there at night and she would pray. And she would ask God, God, is this really what he's supposed to do? And she really knew destiny that was on the inside. I keep talking about destiny. You'll know why later on. But she knew the destiny that was on the inside of me. So once God really gave her the okay, she let go and let God.
Right.
Literally.
Do you have any siblings? Because I've always just known you. We became good friends.
I have two sisters and one brother. I'm okay. The baby of okay. The family, so I'm not spoiled at all.
Yes, you are,
I'm
sir.
I'm not spoiled.
Absolutely. This is good. So you went on the road with me. I remember being on the road with you. And then while we were on the road, you disappeared.
Yes.
You left the play. Mm-hmm. I didn't know why you left the play. Mm-hmm. I just remember getting a phone call in my hotel room, and they said, hey, DeWayne's not going up tonight.
Mm-hmm.
What do you mean DeWayne's not going up tonight? And was it Sam that filled your
Sam,
spot?
Yep, that's right.
Yep, Sam is a good friend of ours. He's a great singer. I forgot his last name.
I did too.
Yep, but Sam filled your spot, and I couldn't believe it because I said, you know, where did DeWayne go? And nobody knew.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was this big mystery, where did DeWayne go? We were, you know, because you become a family on the road, and we're all traveling on the bus. That was before Tyler Perry.
Yeah.
And that was just, you know, everybody got on the bus. You know, at the end of the run in that city, you got your things, you got on the bus, and you went. And I'm like, where is DeWayne?
Mm-hmm.
What happened? Where did you disappear to?
I had taken ill that particular night. We were in Chicago, and I had taken ill that particular night. And so the company manager for the play, Angela Barrow,
Angela.
she said, you need to go and have a physical taken. You need to, because you're out here on the road, we want to make sure that you're okay. So I went to the doctor.
And let's just let me say this, when we're out on the road, we're literally doing 8 shows a week.
Yes.
You know, we're doing
literally
8 shows a week, folks. We're
Tuesday through Sunday.
Monday is the travel day. So we're literally Sunday after the 8 o'clock show, we get on the bus. And we're riding. Monday is the travel day. Tuesday, we unload our stuff in the next city, and mm-hmm. we're there all week performing. 2 shows on Saturday, 2 shows on Sunday.
That's
so
right.
It'll wear your body down. So we're thinking, okay, DeWayne's been worn down. He needs some rest.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And that's what I thought it was.